If there's one thing you could change about the past, what would it be?
There was one thing I could change about my past. First of all, I don't think there was anything that I have gone through that wasn't part of what I was supposed to go through. But if I had to rewrite everything, I think I would learn to accept myself a lot more. But I think when I was growing up, the situation in society wasn't such that it wasn't as open as it was today, right? So people weren't accepting of like strange behaviors they are now. But if I did, and I came to the acceptance of to get to some kind of normalcy within myself as to like not having to prove myself to so many people and not wanting to like work so hard just to be accepted, I think that would be a lot healthier mentally for me.
Thanks for that. Thank you. Bruce, is there anything about your past that you would have changed?
Of course, if I could rewrite, there would be many things. But I guess the turning point in my life from the normal life that I had to the other one was when I joined a gang. That changed everything, you know. So if I could, that would be the one. But like what I've told you before, you know, for me, I've done many wrongs in my life. Am I going to sit down and cry over spilled milk? No, I'm not. All right. That's why I do what I do now. You know, I learn from my past and I go out and share as often as I can with the hope that others will learn from it and not, you know, have to go through the things that I did.
Yeah. What's one way you think now that we, you know, have been talking about this for a while, this stigmatization against, you know, a lot of people that are going through a dark period and are plummeting in their mental health? How do we counter the stigma?
Well, I think society as a whole should be kinder. You know, you may not like it, you may not agree with it, you may be scared of it. That doesn't mean you have a right to comment on it, all right? To add more problems for the person. I mean, hey, it's not called a mental health issue for nothing, right? If others are having an issue already, why do you want to add to that person's issue? If you don't know about it, zip. All right? That's what I think.
Thank you, Bruce.
You're welcome.
What are your thoughts, Samuel?
I think people need to be more compassionate and kinder. I mean the compassion. Actually, when you walk down the streets of Singapore, you see a lot of nice people doing little nice gestures for people.
Yeah.
Don't become a different person when you go online. You know, you don't have to wish ill upon everyone because that's not good for you, your own mental health, I think.
Yeah.
So you need to want to raise up other Singaporeans around you so that together we're happier as a society rather than always be upset that someone else is doing better than you, always be upset that someone else is acting in a way that you don't find acceptable. So I think people need to be nicer, then it'll be a lot easier for the rest of us.
I think there's a lot of competition online, right? People are quite competitive. It's almost like a parallel reality to our actually being in the physical person, right? So they have this opportunity to become these avatars or these personas that they're building up. So I think, yeah, that message about being kind is very much there. But do you think it starts with education or conversations like this? Like, this is a momentous moment, like both of you talking about this.
I haven't dared to talk about this for 5 years.
Wow, okay.
I haven't dared to
Yeah.
talk for 5 years. And I have been talking all the time before. But for 5 years, everyone said, lay low, don't say anything, don't say anything, don't say anything, don't say anything, don't.
And how did that make you feel that you couldn't talk about it?
There wasn't very much for me to say at first because it would have been suicidal. Like, I would have said many things which were depressing. Now I think I've walked through my own valley of darkness, right? So I can talk about it. But I feel as if the government is doing the right thing by saying, like, yes, mental health is important. The Law Society has also come up with initiatives for lawyers to go for like counseling and talks with people. I think lawyers especially take on a very, very tough job. other than being an entrepreneur, running a business, you every client that comes in, their problems are your problems. So I've had like so many people come on and then all of the problems become my problems. So over and above my own entrepreneurial issues about like making the monthly paychecks for everyone, I also have to make sure that they are okay and I'm fighting their cases too. So it is my problems times the problems of so many people.
Yeah.
And I took those responsibilities really seriously.
Yeah.
And I tried to help as many people as I could. But it proved too much for me to take. I wish I would have been able to go and talk to someone. I think we need good counselors.
Mm.
We need good psychiatrists, psychologists. Psychiatrists would just not simply prescribe medication and like, go live your life, right?
Yeah.
No, you don't do that. I mean, you talk to people and talk them through. So the counselors really, if we have very good counselors and if they marketed themselves properly as people who, like people, normal people could even go and talk to, I think that would be very helpful. It will take the stigma away from being mad.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. Yeah, I think talking and being in a safe space where we can be open enough to talk is so important.
Yes.
Bruce, what about you? What do you think?
I agree with what he said. The government is doing the right thing by highlighting these problems. I guess the fear that society had or the stigma came about because of not knowing, you know. That is always people's biggest fear of the unknown, right? But once you get to, once or society gets to understand the problem better, about what entails, what happens, I think they'll be more accepting. Because for my generation, when you said, this person has a mental issue, it is like one thing and one thing only. It's like big time, you know, crazy, like psycho, take a knife, stab you in the back kind of thing.
Yeah.
That is people's perception when you said he has a mental issue.
Mm.
But hey, mental issues has many levels. And I don't think society is really that aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
So education is, I guess, key.
Yeah. So just wrapping up, right? We talked about a few things, right? And some key words that, you know, I'm picking up is like, sometimes people just need to be more open, but they refuse to want to know. And I think that's the first issue, right? Secondly, cancel culture is a real thing. And the internet is a competitive place. It's a little bit like a marketplace, right? If you take it and people talk and they refuse to want to look at two sides of the coin, yeah. Right? And thirdly, we really need more safe spaces to talk about it, because imagine two of you are just two numbers out of a huge statistic, right? If two of you as grown men can feel this way, how do 14-year-old teenagers feel?
And I was not only a grown man, I was a grown man who was a lawyer and who was for ostensibly a very powerful lawyer in Singapore, right?
And winning all those accolades.
Yeah, but when that happened, If I could fall internally and fall inwardly as if I was going to kill myself, I mean, if a kid in school was facing stuff like that, I don't know how those kids survive.
Yeah.
You know, we must be kinder. We must be more compassionate to each other. We cannot go on acting like this.
Yeah. And I salute you both for being so brave and coming out and talking about this. I want more people to hear this, because I think the number one thing that I've really also picked up was, you know, the will to live is more important than losing my life. And unfortunately, like I said at the beginning of our conversation, there are a lot of people out there that don't arrive at that realization, and they do end up, you know, passing on. So we're going to wrap up now. I just want from each of you one tip on how to cope with the challenges of mental stress.
Well, talking is very important. You know, find someone you can trust. Call that person and talk to him. All right. People who are stressed out, they need to not carry that load all by themselves. You know, they might think it cannot be done, nothing can be done, but trust me, all right? Just by talking to a friend, it will help. Yeah. It really does help. Yeah, so reach out.
Thank you. Yeah. example?
I think we must all believe that ultimately life is beautiful. You know that the one who created this beautiful earth cannot have created it only to harm us,
yeah. right?
Or to make our lives miserable. So our lives are not miserable forever. In the longer scheme of things, we have a very short life. And during this short life, we have to make the best of it. Whatever the circumstances are,
yeah.
whether we are happy or we are not happy is a choice.
Yeah.
Whether I woke up that day and wanted to think like, huh, who's going to sabo me today? Or if I woke up and said, never mind, whatever happens, you know, I move on and I'll be stronger.
Yeah.
It's how you view it.
Mm.
And we need to view it differently.
Yeah. So what I've discovered today is, you know, it really does take a village to support one person, but in order for that village to happen, it only takes one person to say, I care. And I think we have really discussed that and felt that today around our circle. So if you have liked our video, please do share, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications. But more importantly, if you'd like to leave a comment, you'd like to discuss and add to the conversation, don't be afraid to leave a comment in the comment section. Also in the description, we have links to our, you know, our NFTs that we are, you know, selling of our City Joes. Thank you so much, Samuel, for being here. Thank you for being so honest and open. And you, Bruce, as well. Thank you so much. We'll see you at our, well, on our next video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.